afternoon. Hotline, may I help you?
Tim Jansen was in Hyattsville on election night. There was no warning.
Hit him like a ton of bricks on election night.
His crisis center flooded with calls.
The angst that was created by the election just sort of bled into all kinds of different places.
Community crisis services usually takes 50 calls a night. On election night, though, they took 450 calls. That's 9 times more than what they're typically set up to handle.
Does it have a contact number?
They did all they could to help, not just Marylanders, but also people across the country, as the National Suicide Prevention Hotline transferred calls to Hyattsville.
We simply gave them a couple of words of wisdom and moved on the best we could, try and prioritize people whose lives are in imminent danger.
But the issue goes beyond election night.
Even though the number of calls has gone down, this suicide prevention hotline says they're still taking more calls than they did before the election.
We're hearing a lot of hate crime sort of stuff, bullying sort of stuff, a lot more of that than we did a month ago.
And while they can try to manage with the increase, they won't be as prepared as they want to be for the next crisis.
We don't expect to get the resources. Running a nonprofit, especially a crisis center, is just a challenge. People don't realize crisis services are needed until they're in crisis.
In Hyattsville, Michelle Chavez, CNS TV.